Hi, my name is Pavel Serenok. In this video, I will show you how to create Excel database and how to connect this database to ODBC driver and then to a PADS designer. Actually, this video based on my previous video, how to create and connect database in Excel format. But sometimes it is necessary to connect database in Excel format. To create a database file in Microsoft Excel, you need to create a few columns with parameters of your components. It is the same way as I explained in my previous video how to create and connect database in Excel format. Be careful with a column value. The column value have to be done in initial values, like ohms, farad, henry, etc. Once your database is finished, it is very important to have a column value, this column, in a format of numbers, not a text. So right-clicked, format, and use a numbers. The second important thing, all numbers in your column value have to be written with a point, not with a comma. If you write your values with a comma, then databook in a PADS designer will recognize your numbers as a text. It will work, but you will not have a possibility to search the values in your database. And also, you will not have a possibility to convert your values automatically to have a right units on your schematic. Okay, once you check format cells in a column value, now we have to create a database from an Excel file. For this, we have to select our column, our table. Right-click and define a name for this page. I will write Excel resistors. Okay, name for page resistor is defined. Now we have to do the same for all our pages. For example, for capacitors. Select all our columns, right click, define names. Excel capacitor. I have written here Excel capacitor and Excel resistor because in my system, one database is already connected, and to separate them, I wrote here Excel capacitor. Okay? Click OK. Okay, once database is created and name of page is defined, we need to save our Excel file in XLS format. The PADS designer works only with this format. Now we have to connect our Microsoft Excel database to ODBC driver. I will do this a little bit faster. because the main steps I explained already in my previous video. Windows sees WOW64, ODB cut, add new, Microsoft Excel driver, XLS, select our file, XLS format. Here you can see the link to this file. Okay, now we'll connect our database to Databook. Right click, configure, edit configuration, add library. Excel resistor, okay. Add table. Excel triple E database, our database that we created. Excel resistors, okay. So here you can see our connected database from Excel file. Now, add library. Excel capacitor, add table, Excel triple database, Excel capacitor. Okay, everything is connected. Okay, so now we will check our connected database. In a window PADS Databook, we open library. So the first two is my previous connected database. And next to is my new connected database from Excel file. I select Excel resistor. And here you can see our values, our parameters from Excel file. So now we will change a view of column value. Instead of 100,000 ohms, I would like to see here 100k. To do this, we have to right click mouse, configure, edit configuration, select Excel resistors, in align value, we have to write units R, magnitude automatic. Now we go to properties, component annotation, and select use European notation for property. From a list we have to select values. So that means that this column value will be converted to European notation. Now, in our column value, we have a normal view of resistors. 100 kilo ohm is 100k. Okay, so we will check our capacitors. Select library Excel capacitor. And here you can see our column value already has a normal view of values. If you open our database with capacitors, here you can see 22 picofarad, but value in the cells we have in farad, 150 picofarad. 150 in a farad is here. It is done in this way because it's very easy to search for a PADS designer. For example, If you want to find some components with a value less than 500 picofarad, I can just write here 500 pico. And PADS Databook select all components with a value less than 500 picofarad. If it would be done in text format, it would not work. If you got a database from another company, and this database has huge amount of cells, and you need to adopt it for your system, I will show you how to make your life a little bit easier. You need to check that in this column you have no commas. In this column have to be only points. Only points. It happened in my case. For example, I got a values in a nanofarad. Like this. And this column value was not recognized by PADS designer. First of all, you have to replace all commas. Select column, Ctrl H, replace commas, here points. Replace everything. Okay, now our column value has a appropriate values with the points. But these values are not in a farad, as PADS designer prefer. These values are in nanofarad. So once we saved our file, we have to restart PADS designer. I did it already. So we select our capacitors. And here in a column value, you can see very nice picture. That capacitor, for example, from column part description, 1 nanofarad, has a value 1 ohm. So this is some kinds of mistake. The problem is that if you select configure, edit configuration, select Excel capacitor, and align value, we will write here magnitude, select automatic, and units. In our database, we have all components in nanofarad. This value has a units nanofarad. So logically, you have to write units here nanofarad. And PADS designer has to convert this value. But it doesn't work. Right click, configure, edit configuration, select our database, Excel capacitor. And here, be careful, in the column units, have to be units in farad. PADS designer recognized ohms, farads, Henry. It knows nothing about nano Henry or milli Henry or micro Henry. Therefore, we got this mistake. If we write here farad and save it, now we have a value of our capacitors in a farads. But they are not correct, because our database values are in nanofarad. This column value has to be in a farads, in ohms, in Henry. If you are not allowed to change this database, you can just ignore this column and use part description. Yes, it is a disadvantage that you can't search your components. The second problem that you can have. If you got your database in a text format, yeah, all columns are in a text format. It is not a numbers, it is text. PADS Designer can recognize these values and automatically convert these values to a numbers. But it can happen that PADS Designer could not recognize it. I don't know why, but it happens in my case. In this case, if you are not allowed to change Excel file that you got from somebody, but you need to work with your database, in this case, you can open DBC file and change this command. Okay, we will open this file. This file is located with your database. EEE database DBC format. This file has to be opened with a Word PADS. And here you can see the tables. This is XML format. This is a first table. This is a second table. This is the first table with transistors. This is the second table with the capacitors. I will search our table with the Excel capacitors. This is our table with Excel capacitor. And here in this table, I have to find the our column value. Here our column value. And for this column, we can find the command value type. Value type tells PADS Designer in which format has to be converted the database. If your database in a text format, here has to be one. If your database in a number format, here have to be two. Normally, PADS Databook convert this automatically. And at the end, do not forget to link symbols for your databook. Setup, settings, project, symbol libraries. And select a folder with your symbols. So my symbols are in a folder sim. Therefore, I need to select the folder one level above. So PADS Designer will recognize in this folder the folder sim. Okay. Here you can see no red cross. If I would select the folder with my symbols, I would get a red cross. This is error. Therefore, one folder above. There is no red cross. And OK. Now we'll select our Excel resistor. And here we have a resistor with a symbol. So I hope this video was helpful for you. If you like this video, and of course, subscribe. It gives me more energy to create new videos, new interesting videos for you. Bye.